as we segue into one of the most outrageous, out-of-the-blue moments from the weekend, I'm going to bring in a comment from Corey, who set this up perfectly. How is Taylor Hall not publicly laughed at for quoting he wants to win and then signing with the Buffalo Sabres? I can't figure out his logic. Can you? So where to begin? I have one friend who knows that is watching that loves the Buffalo Sabres. My best friend's boyfriend, Mitch, is still not recovered from this weekend. I texted them as soon as I found out about Taylor Hall, and it was just like word vomit, like shock and awe from an actual Buffalo Sabres fan. They do exist. I know one, Mitch, but I don't even, if you would have given me like money to bet, it would never have went on the Buffalo Sabres. So this weekend, this happening, obviously he's trying to bet on himself. We get that. You know, that's clearly the case here, but he did say he wants to go somewhere where he can win. He said that. So it's just funny almost. It's kind of sad, but everyone's saying, oh, him and Eichel, like, put some respect on Buffalo. They're going to win this year. I'm like, oh my God, I don't think that's the case. Sorry to Mitch, but yeah.
I don't know. If you're a Buffalo Sabres fan, all Taylor Hall does is screw you out of a lottery pick. Really? Well, I guess every team is in the lottery now. There he is on the Coyotes, a team he will never be remembered for playing for. I literally had to, for a second, I was like, what team is that? Oh, right. He was on the Arizona Coyotes for the hottest of minutes. I'm just surprised the producers were able to find goals for this pack. This is already more goals than I thought he scored with the Coyotes. And I'm not calling Taylor Hall a bad
player. It's the same goal from different angles. Like mine.
from Hall's perspective, the logic makes sense. He, you know, 1 year, $8 million. He made a good point. He's like, I make $8 million to play hockey. Yeah. Like it's not a bad life. This was supposed to be his year to cash in, his summer to cash in the fall. Obviously COVID hit and it screwed a lot of people out of a lot of money. And he was one of them. So he's taken a one-year bet on yourself thing. If I have a bounce back year from what I had last year, maybe teams will have more money as well. I'll have higher value. I can go out and get it. The logic is there. It all makes sense. There's a ton of ifs. And in terms of going somewhere to win, maybe we should have let him finish his sentence so that he could have said at the deadline. Because there's no way. The Sabres could make the playoffs. Stranger things have happened, but I doubt it. The worst thing that could possibly happen is he has a down year and the Sabres miss the playoffs by 1 to 5 points. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? They need to, he needs to do well and they need to stink. That'd be the perfect scenario for him.
It would be. Yeah. Do you think so? I know you mentioned COVID being an issue, obviously. Not many teams had $8 million sitting around to give away to a one-year deal. But, you know, what is it that he said that, oh, I respect the coach. I see young elite talent in Buffalo. I see that the coach, you know, can cultivate that talent. Great owners. He said all this stuff. And I was like, are we talking about Buffalo? We're still talking about Buffalo, right? So I don't know if he's been brainwashed or he's just trying to come in with a really good positive energy, but it's going to be quite interesting to see how this happens because we've seen players lose their love of hockey when they've played in Buffalo. So we're hoping that doesn't happen for Taylor Hall. Someone says, poor Mitch, my friend. Yeah, I know, I agree.
Oh, and Dwayne, the famous Buffalo caller who calls into the radio and loses his mind. Listen, Taylor Hall, former MVP, dirty, dirty liar. Both those things can be used to describe. I know he likes Ralph Kruger, so I do believe that's legitimate. Okay. But in terms of, listen, I'd compliment them too if they gave me $8 million. Put it that way.